Former Conservative MP Dean Del Mastro was convicted last fall of violating the Elections Act, exceeding spending limits, and trying to cover it up. In handing down her sentence today, the judge said Del Mastro was prepared not only to break the rules, but to be deceitful about it. And she said jail time was required. Catherine Cullen has more on this. Catherine.
Peter, a month in jail, 4 months of house arrest, a total of 18 months probation. For Dean Del Mastro, this is clearly an enormous blow, and the image it leaves could be scarring for the Conservatives.
Move to your left, please.
It is a sad spectacle. Dean Del Mastro, in cuffs, fallen so very, very far.
It is reprehensible to make baseless smears in this house.
A big part of Del Mastro's old job was handling questions for the Prime Minister on issues like ethics and accountability. But today the judge said Del Mastro's decision to overspend more than $20,000 on his 2008 election campaign and then try to hide it was an affront to the principles of our democratic system. Adding, cheating is cheating, and in these circumstances, it displays a profound disrespect for democracy and the electorate.
Prime Minister of Canada, the Prime Minister of Canada.
The question now is whether any of this sticks to Stephen Harper.
He picked Dean Del Mastro out of his entire caucus to be the guy to stand up and speak for the Prime Minister on issues of ethics and accountability. The fact that Dean Del Mastro was being sent to the Crowbar Hotel sends a message.
But Del Mastro is part of a growing club of Conservatives investigated by police, including senators and a former staffer.
A former Conservative MP who once served as the Prime Minister's parliamentary secretary is behind bars tonight. Dean Del Mastro was sentenced today for breaking campaign financing laws, then attempting to hide it. CTV's Peter Ackman has more.
Dean Del Mastro walked into court all smiles, brimming with confidence.
Are you nervous about today?
No, not at all.
No?
No, it's just another step.
But 3 hours later, no tie, no laces, and no smile, Del Mastro in shackles shuffled into a transport van bound for jail. Ironically, Del Mastro, as parliamentary secretary, spoke on behalf of Stephen Harper and the party when facing electoral fraud allegations. But the NDP say it's part of a pattern.
No prime minister in Canadian history has shown such consistently bad judgment.
The opposition points out the Harper Conservatives have been convicted of cheating in every election they've won. Campaign staffer Michael Sona was found guilty of the 2011 robocall scandal. And the party pleaded guilty to the in-and-out spending scheme in 2006.
A big fall from grace for a man who was once one of Prime Minister Harper's most trusted advisors. This is Dean Del Mastro in handcuffs and leg irons on his way to prison. The first former member of parliament jailed for violating Canada's election law.